Caution lights are out, green flag in hand. We're going to try to do it one more time in a turn four. Dan Dabo will lead the field to the green flag. Turn three, here comes a 37 to Rob Mayo.
Headbangers and lather.
He clears Elliott. He is your new leader, Rob Mayo.
Sparks flying in the dead of the night.
And look at the big move by Campos. And
it all comes together.
Oh, a flip down in turns one and two. John Campos, upside down, red flag is out.
50,000 watts of power.
Look at the response of that safety team.
And it's pushing overload.
Turns Dream Fire and Rescue, the best in the business.
The beast is ready to devour.
Live from the Jetstream Aqua Massage Studio in Albany, Oregon, you're listening to Northwest Dirt News on Spreaker Radio.
All right, it's time for another edition of Northwest Dirt News here from the Jetstream Aqua Massage Studio in the house with widescreen Gillette Memora, Mr. Warren Simpson. I am Corey Penfold, Moxie Meeting Promotions. Guys, it's been a couple weeks. A lot has been happening. Lots going on. There's been a lot of talk with some recent developments. We're going to talk about some of that tonight. We've got an awesome, it's going to be a great call-in interview tonight. You guys know who it is. It's kind of a surprise to the listeners. We've got an in-studio guest that's going to be here. We're going to do 2 hours tonight, 6 to 8. And it's going to be a good show. We're going to have some fun.
Yeah, it should be a good show, Corey. I mean, we've been texting back and forth, the three of us, and it's just the what's going to happen on this show is going to be insane.
It is.
With all the people that are showing up, all the people that are calling in. Race fans, for you out there in listening land, it's going to be off the hook.
It is going to be a good one. So
it will be a good show tonight.
I'm excited.
Absolutely.
About it. So let's start with your week, your last 2 weeks, Joel. Anything notable to talk about? Something's going to happen to you.
Oh, besides Icemageddon?
Yeah, that was bad.
Dude, that was insane. I don't know what happened up here, but I live between Albany and Harrisburg in the little nice little farming community of Halsey. I think that was in the bubble because everything south of me got freezing rain up the wazoo. Everything north of me got snow. So here I am driving home on whatever night that was, and I'm driving on ice. Then I get home and it starts snowing, and then it starts freezing raining again.
Bad combination.
And you were driving in that?
Oh yeah, I'm not a Californian. I know how to drive. Sorry, Clay Daly. I'm not picking on you, but it happens, brother.
So any that's it. That for it, you? Just the weather.
Just the weather. I mean, everything else has been good to go.
Status quo.
Nothing off the hook. Crazy. Got together with a bunch of my racetrack family this last weekend. Had a little Christmas shindig, and
cool.
It was
again,
a lot.
Invited, Warren. Well, I wasn't either.
It wasn't my party to throw. Otherwise, I would have said, Warren, Corey, stay the heck away.
Let's see how it goes.
But, you know, it's the way it rolls, folks.
It's all good.
We have fun.
I'm surprised you were out driving in it, Joel. I mean, from your text a couple of weeks ago.
When it was raining?
When it was raining, he thought he might not be able to make it because of the flood, the impending flood.
Right.
Hey, you know what? My name is Joel, not Noah, and I do not have an ark. Okay?
You have a Ford.
That was
right.
Quick.
It'll sink.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, it'll sink.
You know what Chevy stands for, right?
Winner circle, baby.
No,
that's victory.
Shove it or leave it.
Well, it's all
you know what Ford stands for?
I can't How say those kind of words on the air, Joel.
First on race day,
no,
thank
flipped,
you very much.
Flipped, or there's the other F word.
Well, hey, don't.
Found on roadside dead.
Yeah.
We don't want to say the F word on the air. We've had a few of those this last race season.
We did.
Thankfully, everybody's okay, but John Campos.
We all survived.
Yes.
You know, I was watching Katie Nolan's Garbage Time, and she gets away with quite a few harsh words on that show. So I thought, what the hell?
So, Warren, let's talk about your last couple of weeks.
It's
anything?
Very uneventful.
Nothing?
It was snow and ice, and I pretty much just stayed at home, and I didn't want to be out there with all the crazies. And
you've fully recovered from the bug you had. You were down for
weeks. Yeah, finally.
Which is good.
I'm good.
You look good. Look
Thanks.
A lot better.
Thanks.
It's just same over here. Status quo business has been completely insane in Jetstream Aqua Massage. You guys have seen it out there.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Steady flow of customers and gift certificates and other merchandise flying out the door. This month has been very, very hectic.
Well, you guys are running a sale here at Jetstream on your TENS units, right?
We are. All TENS units are on sale, and it's been a very popular item.
That's good. Yeah. I know I enjoy mine.
I do, too.
Yeah, Warren.
I use it all the time. It sits on my table. it gets halfway down on the battery, I'm charging it because I don't want it to be dead. You know?
Right. Oh, man.
Yeah, I use it constantly.
Well, and much like myself, Warren uses his at the racetrack when we're doing a show. You know, he's on the quad, and he's up and down, and it does help quite a bit.
Yeah, and I wish I could do that, but being in a fire suit and working with Extreme, I can't have the flammable stuff on me, unfortunately. Right. Otherwise, I would have that on me all night long.
Because
when you're yarding cars off and, you know, pulling people out of cars, it's not fun.
Mm-hmm. I'm visualizing summertime when you say that.
Yeah, I am too. I'm looking forward to it.
I'm done with winter, man. I'm ready for some nice weather and some racing.
Well, and there will be you guys will be doing a show as host and co-host yourself, as I'll be heading out for a short vacation in January.
Oh, boy.
Oh, boy. Hang on. That'll be fun.
$20 says I know where he's going.
Yeah, 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 we all know.
Where's that?
Are you flying on Alaska Airlines again?
No, we're not flying on Alaska Airlines. They won't let us fly on Alaska anymore. No, I'm just kidding.
Really? You're on the TSA list?
No.
Yeah, something to do with that rash.
Yeah.
You know what? I've heard penicillin is a wonder drug.
We're actually flying Hawaiian this time around.
Oh, so I wonder where you're going.
That's Alaska?
The Big Island.
Oh.
Yeah, we're going to the Big Island.
So you're going to Antarctica?
Yes.
Right on.
Only it's 80 there and
Continent 7.
Yeah. Paradise.
Oh, you're going to Hawaii again.
Yes, sir.
I could have guessed.
Yeah, Kona. So looking forward to it. So you guys will be doing that show by yourself. You guys can handle it.
I don't know. You might find me in a suitcase.
Warren?
Nice.
I don't think they make a garment bag big enough for you, buddy, because you're so dang tall.
Yeah, that's it. Right, right.
Well, we could customize something.
Yeah, we could.
Yeah, I'm down.
We're pretty good at customizing
the weather right now.
Here's the thing. If you know anything about Warren, okay, Warren is – he loves the sun. Now, I can take him over there with us, but I'll promise you one thing. He won't be coming back.
Probably not.
You know, we'll be on the bird. He'll be flipping the bird. You know what I mean?
See ya.
He won't be coming back from Hawaii.
He won't be the only one giving you the bird that run around, but, you know, it happens.
So how long are you going to be gone?
We will be gone for 8 days. We'll be gone from the 28th through the 5th, and my birthday falls right in the middle of that. So,
and what birthday is this?
Old. It'll be
No. Try again.
Number 43.
43.
Yep.
Huh.
I can't believe that.
Hey, isn't your favorite NASCAR driver's number 43?
No. No. What is NASCAR?
Oh, let's
go. Is that
go
something
on this.
New?
Oh man,
I'll get you guys converted.
We'll get you converted.
Oh, I will get you converted.
I'll tell you what. The only thing that's going to convert me away from NASCAR is Courtney Force.
No, I'll tell you.
That would work.
It's really easy. Here's the easiest way to convert yourself from NASCAR. Grab yourself a soda.
Look at the time.
No,
check. Check.
Sit on the couch. Start watching a race. And watch how fast you go to sleep.
Oh, dude, it's 30 laps.
Best. Nap car. So, Warren, that being said, are you guys ready to rock and roll tonight? We've got a lot of stuff to talk about.
Let's rock and roll.
Okay. So, first on the list here, let's talk about – it's getting closer. We kind of had a conversation about it here in the last couple of weeks about the car show. This thing is getting it's getting big. And if you guys are wanting to get a car for you guys that are listening, if you're wanting to get a car in this show, you better start contacting us quick because we are limited to 32 spots. 32 spots.
Remaining.
32 spots.
32 spots.
32
total,
total spots.
And it's filling up quick. I mean, it is filling up quick. So if you want to get a spot, you can contact us through Moxie Media on Facebook, private messages. If you got my phone number, you can text message, call, email us, nwdirtnews@yahoo.com. It's very easy to get a hold of us. So I'm telling you, it's going to be a big deal this year.
Yeah, it's going to be great.
We've got some neat features that we're going to release just, you know, from Moxie, and we've got a lot of people really excited about this already. It's been a popular topic throughout the off season.
And somebody's coming in to talk about that tonight.
Well,
with
that'll
us,
be another event coming up. We're going to have somebody else talking about that.
Okay.
So, it's going to be exciting. I'm looking forward to it.
A lot happening for the off season.
This is the time where things are really starting to shift gears. You know, we kind of went through the downhill and now we're coming back up the slope, and we're starting to see some events pop up. And
you get past Christmas here.
Well, and you look at it, too. The off season is really when the race car drivers shine. I mean, they shine on the track every weekend, but you look at the fabrication work. You look at the sheet metal work that they put into these cars. And the Northwest Race Car Show, presented by Jetstream Aqua Massage and Moxie Media Promotions, is the place they can do that.
Right.
Cars don't get dented. Cars don't get tire marks.
They're shiny. They're
shiny.
The sponsors are readable.
You can come in, and it's best for the fans, too, because you can get up and you can touch that car. You can look at that car. You can meet the driver behind the wheel that you don't get to see up in the stands.
Well, and that's one of the things we'll talk about is we will, at the car show this year, we will have – last year we did it on a smaller basis. We're going to do it on a bigger basis this year, on a bigger foundation. Driver autograph sessions with interviews, pictures. It's going to be a cool deal. You know, Doc's photos will be here taking snapshots of the cars for drivers and teams and sponsors. And it's going to be a fun deal.
And for those of you that can't make it, Northwest Dirt News will be there.
Yes, we will.
We will be there all weekend long, bringing you the latest and greatest from the drivers.
That's right.
Right out of their mouths.
Yep. And it's going to be fun. So I did have a conversation with a Mr. Jerry Schramm. And to, you know, like we talked about, ending all rumors, this is what the tentative schedule is looking like, 20 to 23 races.
At Willamette.
That's going to be a good show for this year.
So they just released the rules.
Yes.
You guys saw that on Facebook. The new 2017 Willamette Speedway rules were released. Not a whole lot of surprise as to what they did. We all knew the G60 tire was coming for the street stock division. Other than that, I mean, we knew the spoiler to the engine, you know, for the late models, with the crate engines getting bigger spoilers, and the 525 getting a 10-inch as opposed to 12 that the crates get, and then an 8-inch spoiler for the open motors. You know, trying to balance it out for everybody throughout the field.
I think it's going to be good this year, because you're going to see, especially in our super late model division, you're going to see the horsepower to spoiler ratio more equally matched between all the different packages you can run.
Okay, real quick. Do you really think that is going to balance the field simply by spoiler height? Do you think it's going to level the playing field enough to it makes a big difference?
Is it going to level the playing field enough on a hooked up track? Absolutely not.
Right.
You will not see a 604 crate whip the pants off of Rob Mayo in the number 37 Black Diamond with a Coronet motor. You will not see it. End of story.
But the 525 it's
no slouch.
It's not, and it can hold its own. And Brian Kronk did, and Weinbarger as well. Those two drivers last year did a heck of a job of proving those engines are something that a lot of guys, I think, will start making the transition to. For the cost and the power you get and the competition to get those engines, I mean, dollar for dollar, for a racer, that's probably the most bang for your buck right now.
I have talked to more late model drivers than I can even think of right now. Hey, what are you doing this year? What are you doing for this year? What's your new big purchase? Over half of them are saying, I'm getting a CT525.
Mm-hmm. I think we're going to see a lot of those next year.
You're going to see a lot of CT525s and 10-inch blades out there. Now, do I think the spoiler is going to help the horsepower, help it level the playing field?
I think in August, when it's 100-plus degrees out,
absolutely,
I think it'll make a big it'll make a difference.
Absolutely.
Will it make enough to where visually you're going to say, wow, that really does? I don't think it will.
But
I like the idea. Do I think it's going to make the biggest change in the world? I don't think it'll really affect the field top to bottom where a guy that wasn't competitive also, you know, is now winning the
AMA.
It's
still going to all be about setup.
Well, that's what it is.
It always will be.
See, and that's the thing. Thank you. Willamette Speedway. I don't care how much horsepower you have. Willamette Speedway is a setup racetrack.
Mm-hmm. I mean, wasn't it Joey Tenner that went out there a couple of races? Was that in his car or somebody else's?
That was in Walter's.
In Walter, right.
He won 3 races with that thing.
With a crate.
Yep.
Right, absolutely.
So you know, again, when it's dry slick and you've got 900 horsepower and the guy that's got 550, you know, is hooking it up, you know, it's almost to their advantage. It's going to be interesting to see. But I like the rule. I like that, you know, that they've acknowledged that, hey, look, we're going to do the best we can to make it fair for everybody. And, I mean, you can't argue with it. No. I think it's a good call.
I think it'll work. I mean, well, it's going to have to for now.
For the last couple of years, the rumor going around the track has been – or, excuse me, not the track, Willamette Speedway has been they want to make the late model class affordable. That's the rumor that's been going around, is that the promoters want to make the class affordable. Mm-hmm. Well, I think this is the best step forward to making the class affordable.